There is nothing more important to a studio owner or a general creator of digital things than their data. I mean, my whole studio can burn down and it's all replaceable, kind of. But data isn't replaceable. Data is generated by us humans and you cannot replace data. The biggest mistake you can ever make is not securing your data. So today I'm going to demonstrate you how I'm backing up all of my data without having a proper internet connection. So the internet connection I have in the studio over here is an internet connection that's, well, I think even older than my console, than my old vintage console. It's, I think the upload is like 3 megabit or something. Like, it takes about 1 hour to upload one single song as WAV. That's how bad the internet is over here. So clearly backing up to the cloud isn't directly possible. I made a few, well, lines of defense for my own data. So the first thing I'm doing is I'm running Time Machine on my Mac Pro to an internal hard drive that backs up automatically every hour, I think, and keeps backups also from the past. And the good thing about that is that if my main working drive will crash right now, I will only lose about an hour of work, which isn't that bad after all. The cool thing about Time Machine is that it also keeps an kind of an archive. So if I make a big mistake in a project, I can go back into Time Machine, actually go back into time and catch the old project file or the old files of something. But my hard drive can crash, but my Mac Pro can also catch fire. So that isn't enough. What you could do in this situation is pick a big USB hard drive, back up everything to a USB hard drive and take that hard drive home with you every single day. And that's a good solution, but it's not the best because there's a human element in there. That's the first thing, a human element. You need to remember to take the hard drive home every single day because if this place will burn down and the hard drive's also here, then your data is gone. But there's another element in here. I mean, if the hard drive is over here, is in this building while I'm backing up and the building catches fire and I run outside, then still my data is gone. Taking a hard drive with you every day isn't waterproof, isn't airtight, isn't, you know what I mean. So what I'm doing is I'm using a program called Carbon Copy Cloner, which clones my project folders every day at around 5 o'clock to my MacBook. This works over Wi-Fi and over an Ethernet connection. Over Wi-Fi it only takes a bit longer, but it's still like 5 minutes every day. And since I always leave the studio at like 5:30, I'm always sure that I have the latest files on my MacBook. Which is, by the way, also handy if you need to open a project at home or, you know, if you're on the road and need to check something in a project. It's handy that you have all the projects on your laptop as well. I do have to say that I have an older MacBook with the CD-ROM drive replaced for a 1 terabyte hard drive so it can hold those files. But we're still not watertight on our backups now because, well, I do have it on my laptop, but my laptop is next to my Mac Pro right now. So it's still not watertight. My laptop is the thing that I take home every day because I also use it at home and I use it, I mean, I always have it with me. And my home does have a fast internet connection. It's like, it's really fast. And while my laptop is at home, it backs up to the cloud. I personally use Backblaze for my backups, but I'm not affiliated with them. So every single cloud service could work. You could also use a Dropbox or a Google Drive, or as long as it's backed up. With those daily backups to the cloud, my data is always safe. So even if this whole thing burns down over here, like the whole building burns down, I still have my data in the cloud. So that's how I'm backing up my data. And when you're going to look for your own backup process, always think of the worst case scenario. I mean, if you ask a lot of people why they back up, they say, well, if my hard drive crashes. That's not all that can happen. There's also a risk in having all of your data in one physical location, which is, in my case, my studio. You always want to have a second location, you know, far away from where your original location is to make sure that you keep your data. So this is what happens to my normal, like working projects. So the archive of projects that I don't work on anymore are stored on two Drobos. I have one over here. Projects that I don't work on anymore, I store it on this Drobo, which has a lot of hard drives in here. I think this is 10 terabytes worth of hard drives or something. So I'm storing it on this thing. I do have another Drobo at my home. Again, different physical location, where I store the same projects as an archive, which makes sure that also my archive doesn't get lost. I am running into a problem with the archive because I'm starting to get more data than I can store on these Drobos. I still don't know what to do with my YouTube data, because should I keep every project? I'm still keeping every single project I've made, but I think I'm going to delete them because I don't see a reason why I should keep all the raw footage. But still not sure about that. And what I want to do in the future is build a storage server, build two storage servers, one over here and one at my home, that will keep all that data. We're talking about like a lot of terabytes of data, really, if I'm also going to store all the video files. And it's right now not possible to store that in a cloud somewhere, or it will get really expensive, like really expensive. So yeah, that's my 2018 backup strategy video. I did also one last year, but I think I'm even more watertight than I was last year in terms of backing up. This video was requested a lot, by the way, so I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, let me know with a thumbs up. Comment below with suggestions for future videos or your own backup strategies. I'm really interested in hearing how you guys make sure that you never lose your data. This video was sponsored by patrons. You can also sponsor me by clicking over here. You get early access to my videos and one extra video every week, if I remember to make them. And you can check out one of my other videos over here, so check it out. Thanks a lot for watching this video, and I'll see you guys again after the weekend somewhere. I don't know. Bye bye.